winter had come, and for many days now I held everything in an icy grip. The countryside was frozen hard. Trees were white with frost, and icicles hung from bridges and water columns. Mercifully, there was little snow. It's too cold for that, thank goodness, shivered James's driver, as he and the fireman held within the sheltered sunny cab. James had an open footplate, and every day, his crew came to work muffled to the eyebrows and scarves and jeans. Sometimes, most cars froze too, and then the engines could not get the warmth they needed. But this never happened at the local station, and one day, when the frost seemed harder than ever, James' driver stopped him beside the water column there. We'll give you a good topping of what we can, he said. There's no telling when we might get some more. James shook the icy water, cascading into his tinder, but he knew his driver was right. He filled James's tank to the brim. Guess the fireman forgot to tell the driver to turn the tap off. Water overflowed over James's tinder, making him shiver again. Right, said the fireman, jumping down to the footplate. Let's go. I want to warm myself up from being cold. We can't go yet, laughed the driver. They haven't finished loading the luggage van. Well, I do wish they'd hurry, grumbled the fireman, blowing on his hands. I'm frozen from staying on that tender. All engines have a tap called an injector. It allows the driver or fireman to transfer water from the tender to the boiler, and it's very important. Without it, the water from the boiler could become too low to make steam properly. They had not gone far before James felt thirsty. I need a drink, please, he said. The driver switched on the injector, but nothing happened. Still nothing. I've got such a pain, moaned James. Your injectors failed, said his driver. Blockage in the pipe, most likely. You better stop and dealt with your fire.
Can't go on without water.
Don't set the sleepers alight, I cheated James. You would never let me forget it. The fireman laughed. You'll be all right if you just dump it down, he said. We never dumped the fire out as Henry did. We stopped near a signal box, and James's driver asked the signalman to telephone for help. The works sent a diesel, one James had never met, to help him. Rescued by a diesel, he snorted disgustingly. It's degrading. I won't go. But he soon changed his mind because now his fire was down and the boiler was cooling, and he could feel the icy winds. The diesel was friendly. James was quiet at first.
Smile. If you only knew what I'm going through, I just can't smile without you.
When they reach the works, the deuces are running over, and the two of them are chatting like old friends. At the works, James is finally bound under the tender. He tried to open the filler cap, but couldn't. "There's your answer, James," he said. "Your filler cap's frozen solid. That's because the water overflowed. Because of this, ice is stopping air from getting into the tank, so the injectors can't work. You'll be alright once the ice melts." He was, and that wasn't all. Thanks to his new friend from the works, even James now admits diesels can be used for engines too.